Hi guys, I'm Tanya and welcome back to my channel, The Donkey Business. Today I am here to talk about a bunch of recommendations that I watched on OTT. It is currently streaming. I'm very excited to talk about it. I have watched all of this in the last 1 week and they're all great recommendations. And here is my list of what you can watch through the coming week. So the first thing that I watched is a documentary. The first episode is available for free on Prime Video and then you have to get the premium subscription to watch it further. It's called Quiet on Set, The Dark Side of Kids TV. If you're a 90s kid or like early 2000 or a bit before that, you have grown up watching Nickelodeon. And Nickelodeon had some of our favorite shows, favorite characters. We have all grown up watching Nickelodeon. I was such a Nickelodeon fan and the jingle of Nickelodeon still rings in my ears. So Nickelodeon was literally every kid's dream. We wanted to act with Nickelodeon, work with Nickelodeon, come back from school and watch Nickelodeon. And some of our favorite shows come from Nickelodeon. But did you know that it is actually a very dark business for kids? It is basically so dark that I was honestly depressed while watching it because they have mentioned some things which I did not even imagine was happening on the sets of a Nickelodeon show. The kids were traumatized, they were abused emotionally, sexually, there were racist remarks, there was body shaming remarks, a very popular actor from a very popular show was sexually harassed. Two levels which he could not even speak about on television in this documentary. It is a very heartbreaking documentary. I highly recommend it. I don't want to give any spoilers of who the actor was or what exactly happened with him. But when Me Too happened, the creator of a lot of Nickelodeon shows was taken behind the bars and it shows about how toxic Nickelodeon is. And yeah, I mean, I was disgusted while watching it. It's got 100% ratings on Rotten Tomatoes and I highly recommend it because it's just so true, but it's just so bad. The next thing that I want to recommend is called The Bear. I have finished all three seasons of The Bear, so it's an interesting story. I started watching The Bear when it came and I watched season 1, episode 1 when it released and I really liked it. And I knew that there are going to be a lot of seasons of this show and a lot of important episodes and I should watch it once it's all out. So I have now finished watching all three seasons of The Bear and I love it. The good thing about it is that it has so much energy throughout the show and very less information on characters that suddenly you just become a part of their characters, you know, like supposing I watched The Boys and I liked the first three seasons, sure, but by the time I waited for fourth season and watched it, I had forgotten most of it and I didn't know what to expect and I didn't even like it. And so I just watched like one episode of the new season of The Boys and gave up. But with The Bear, even if I had watched one season per year, I think I would have still remembered everything because the life is so slow, but it is still so fast every day, you know, like they're all building a hotel, one of the best restaurants in the world. But I mean, it's a slow process, but it's a very tedious process, right? And that's what The Bear is about. It's a very good show. It's very well made. I was not the biggest fan of season 2. I think it was pretty chaotic and emotional for no reason. But season 1 and season 3 was my absolute favorite. It is available on Disney. It's a new show. It is very different from what I generally talk about or recommend. It is not your murder thriller. It is a drama and a very well-made drama. I highly recommend it. It's called The Bear and the acting is so good by everybody. Jeremy White is my new crush for sure. And I highly recommend The Bear. It's available on Disney Plus Hotstar. The next thing that I watched is called Cocaine Bear, which is available on Netflix and had a very interesting story, but I didn't like the execution that much, to be honest. So Cocaine Bear is about a bear who is in this jungle and there was this flight that was carrying a lot of cocaine and the flight blasted, so all the cocaine fell in this jungle and this bear gets addicted to the cocaine. So the things he does and the way he harasses people till the time they figure out that it's actually cocaine. So the film is about that. It's a very interesting take. I was actually very excited to watch it because I thought it would be really funny to watch a bear on cocaine. But honestly, it was not that impactful as I thought it would be. It's well made in a lot of ways. The bear has done good acting as well. He was pretty interesting and entertaining when he was on cocaine, but I think that it was not as impactful and enjoyable. After a point, I was like, what is even the story? You know, like, what are they trying to show? It was just a good concept, but very poor execution. It's available on Netflix. Watch it if you want to. I mean, it's an exciting idea, but the film was not that good and I did not enjoy watching it. The next thing that I watched is the Rajkumar Rao film Shrikant, who was in theaters for a very long time and now has finally come on Netflix. I had heard a lot about it when it was in the theaters, but I didn't get a chance to watch it, and I watched it on Netflix very recently. Rajkumar Rao obviously is an amazing actor, and I think in this movie also he's done an incredible job. However, with the story, I think the writing was pretty loose. It is an inspiring story based on true events about a man who was born blind and how he reached the highest levels of education and did a lot for the community of his village, even though his village and his parents also did not want him to live when he was born. So the movie is very inspiring, but I think that it had a lot of loose ends. I mean, the real struggle of Rajkumar Rao is not really shown. It was like whatever he wanted, he got it, and that's how he reached this whole egoistic situation, and in the end he apologized. I mean, it is a story that you tell a child when the child is growing so that he does not turn out to be an egoistic person. But as a movie, I think when you're making a movie on true events based on a person, then it has to be something like very impactful, and somehow this movie was very plain. Watch it for the positivity, watch it for Rajkumar Rao, watch it to know what Shrikant is, but apart from that, I don't think I really enjoyed the film and I don't really recommend it. The next thing that I watched is called Bad Cop, which is currently streaming on Disney Plus Hotstar. Anurag Kashyap is in the series, but he's not directed it. And the story is so stupid. It's about two brothers. One is a good person who becomes a good cop, and one is a bad person who becomes a thief. The good cop dies in a situation, and the thief steps into the shoes of the good cop to behave like the good cop, to be the good cop basically, and find out who killed his brother. And they are both twins, so he can actually do that. I mean, it is so over dramatic, so overstretched, the jokes are so bad, the story is so bad, everything about the show is so bad. I've seen four episodes, and I think the first season only has four episodes. I don't know why Anurag Kashyap is doing such stuff. He was not really needed. His acting is good, I like his screen presence, but what is his character? And I mean, it's such a bad show, I don't recommend it. I think we have way better content to watch from around the world. I don't understand what is wrong with the Hindi film industry these days, but sure, these are some things that I watched in the past week, out of which I really recommend Quiet on Set, very nice, The Bear, very nice, Cocaine Bear, you can watch it if you want, Shrikant, yeah, watch it, not bad, Bad Cop, please remove it if you've added it to your list and dislike it so that you're not recommended stuff like that. I didn't like it at all. But I'll see you next week with another bunch of recommendations. Thank you so much for watching my video, and please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.